Welcome back to Dracon's Plays. Dark Souls. Alright, so I noticed two things. That treasure chest in the corner. Which is really hard to get to. Hawk ring. Okay, made it out. The other is actually inside on the top floor of Ornstein and Ornstein and Smog's arena. So I was here grinding to get the last of the twinkling titanite, since that's what the giant blacksmith smells. The giant blacksmith sells that. So I was here getting the last of it, and I just upgraded my armor, so it's all +5. So all of my main gear is good. I don't have a lightning shield that I particularly preference, just because the physical defense on them isn't as good. But so I noticed that treasure chest. So now we got the hawk ring. The other item, the other thing I noticed, was a glow way down here, which I realized was a weapon, or not a weapon, but an item of some kind. Helm of Favor. Embraced Armor of Favor, Gauntlets of Favor, Leggings of Favor. Alright. So, we're gonna go back and see what the item descriptions for this stuff is. Let's see. Helm of Favor. Helm of Loretic the Embraced, representing the goddess Fina's love. During his solitude, he forsake everything, for he believed in the goddess's love for him. The goddess's arms wrap around it, as if to embrace the wearer. During his solitude... Alright. Solitude. Cool. Hawk ring. Got it. One of these special rings granted to the four knights of Gwyn. The hawk ring belonged to Hawkeye who led the great archers. Boosts bow range so that arrows may fly like they were shot by Gaw's great bow, which took down high-flying dragons. Nifty. Alright. So, our stuff is all fully upgraded now. Let's warp to Firelink Shrine. Alright, let's see. I'm going to deposit my extra weapons and armor. And then we'll be ready to go, I believe. Let's see. So just keep my four good ones, get rid of stuff like that. Keep on going. So much junk. Now we want that bow, just like we want that crossbow, pyromancy flame. We do want one skull lantern on us. Effigy shields are current lightning. As I said, I don't have a strong preference towards it, so I'm not gonna upgrade it like I did the others. Crash shield. Alright. And then armor. I really wish this was better. It, like, literally the setup of this is the worst. Excuse me. I don't know if the camera picked it up, but... Okay, I'm full of gas. Alright, I believe that's all of it. while we're here. There we go. Repaired all my equipment. Alright, so this may very well end up being the finale. Or the second to last episode. Oh, he's sleeping. I hate waking you, buddy, but... Oh. Okay.
No, no, I'm fine. I'm fine. Well and wide awake.
Yeah.
Do not treat me like an old withering snake.
Sorry. You were literally sleeping on the job.
I am pleased to see you well.
I wouldn't hit characters, but I read this happens sometimes. Okay. Warp.
Very well.
And he eats us. Loading. He eats us, brings us down below. Now we'll be down below. Actually, I never actually talked to you.
I am pleased. The beings who possess these souls have outlived their usefulness.
Yep.
Farewell, chosen.
I never actually looked at this. The stairs just end. Alright. So he doesn't have anything else for us. Rested Lord Vessel. Offer souls to Lord Vessel. There we go. That is quite a blaze now. Fire's clipping through the bottom. Oh, okay. Understood. The entire thing's on fire. Okay, and those doors are opening up. Interesting. Rested Lord Vessel. 20 Estus? You have anything to say about that?
Ah.
You do.
Oh. The Lord Vessel is satiated.
Yes, it is.
Magnificent. You are the righteous successor to Gwyn, the new great lord, and I am King Seeker no more. Your acquaintance was an honor. I must admit, I am fond of you humans. May you enjoy serendipity, and may the Age of Fire perpetuate.
Thank you. Yeah, that is really, really ablaze. What the heck? Oh, that is weird. Whoa. Kiln of the First Fire? Kiln of the First... whatever. Holy crap. That looks really cool. Oh, alright. I got your number. All right. Hey, tonight, chunk. Let's see. This place is crazy. But is the entire level just this? Red Titanite chunk. Yeah, those guys are like the Black or Silver Knights. Holy crap. Yeah, I think we're in the finale. There's just piles of what I think this is ash. Which would make sense. That item. Titanite chunk. This place is weird. Black Knight. Alright, that's the entire Black Knight armor set. So I have their shield. I got one of their great swords early on. So I actually almost have everything. So what? I have the sword and the firebird? Or, yeah. All right. This area looks amazing, but it's stupid linear. And with just these guys. White Titanite chunk. Black Knight Hellbird. Alright, so just the axe and the regular sword, then. I think is all missing. Okay. I think this is the end of the game. So I'm gonna pause it for a second, copy the save, and then we'll take that on. Alright, so I'll be right back. Alright, so, Turns out PlayStation 3's copy protection is stupid, and I need PlayStation Plus to be able to back up the save data on this game. That is stupid. Gwyn, Lord of Cinda. Oh my. Around the pillar? You've got to be kidding me. Holy crap. I have not even gotten a blow on him. I got it right as I said that. That is ridiculous. Okay. He does not give you much breathing. I am dead. That grab is ridiculous. Holy crap. This has got me challenging in weird ways. Oh, and it's a heck of a run. At least they give me a crap ton of Estus. And getting back to him sucks, because it's a long distance, and there's multiple Black Knights in the way. Because I'm assuming since it's the last area, they respawn. Great. So that's Gwyn. Yeah, they respawn. I see that one. Alright. And they're a little... They chase you quite a ways. I'll be better off just fighting them. Alright. So I'm gonna pause it here. And I'll come back when we get back to Gwyn. Alright, and we're back. Oh my god, great. Or not. Alright, here we go again. Double grab? Okay. Nice to see that my fire ring actually works. Oh. Oh, this is ridiculous. Ridiculous. Give me a chance to heal. Thank you. This is just nonsense. Come on. This is actually ridiculous. Not not making any progress. Thank you for getting cleaned up for 1 second there. Oh, this is gonna take forever. We're getting in blows, though. This is ridiculous. I mean, holy crap. Doing it. And by doing it, I mean kind of, and very slowly. Oh, that grab. This is just an annoying fight. I mean, holy crap. It's slow as all heck. Out of everything swinging. Literally. A dish. Whoever designed him did not. Really think about it. Ow. Okay, this is slow. Oh, come on! Turns into just a, oh no, I took damage. I need to get away. So that I can heal. Blocked 99% of it. hit my character kick instead of swinging. Doing it, but it just takes forever. All right, back away from the corner. Stupid that we literally have to get him hung up on pillars to heal. Because eating any two of his attacks is death. Dang it! Why is this arena set up just as random? Oh my... Dude, this guy is annoying. I'm just gonna come back when I beat him. Gotcha! Yes. Soul of Gwyn, Lord of Cinder. All right. 70K. Link the Fire. This is the point where I really wish I had an ability to back it up. Because I'm going to have to replay the entire game now. That's okay. I'll be better at it, and I'll have a better feel for it, and I'll figure it out. Anyways, Link the Fire, I guess. Now I'm on fire. Whoa. Whoa. Okay. To Link the Fire. We did it. Yes. We beat Dark Souls. Miyazaki. Really good designer. So, that was Dark Souls. I'm not 100% sure the explanation on the story on this one. I'm going to be looking up videos and other stuff to explain this in Dark Souls 2 before I start playing Dark Souls 3 tomorrow. And I'll put up a vlog. Well, you guys already know all that. But anyways, yeah. I really did, the combat in this one felt really good. Better than Dark Souls 2, except for some moments like Gwyn, which was horrible. Gwyn was bad. There's a few other moments where it's just like, what? Bed of Chaos, which I fought tonight in this session, was another one where it's like, that was the hardest easy boss ever. That one was mostly me, but there was just some of them where it didn't quite feel fair, but most of it was amazing. The level design in this one blew Dark Souls 2 out of the water. The level design was spot on. Because it was like you'd found the shortcuts, you realized how everything was interconnected and linked. It was really cool. And it's like, yeah, you thought that guy was required? No, there was actually a shortcut that went around him if you looked. It's just really crazy to think about. Bloodborne really had that too. And I really hope Dark Souls 3 does. I'll know tomorrow, since I'm playing it then. That's when it comes out. So yeah, this is pre-recorded way in advance of release. In anticipation of Dark Souls 3. But anyways, yeah, I really enjoyed this one. I can definitely see why everyone likes this more than Dark Souls 2. Still has a few problems with it. I hope the DLC is amazing. It might end up being a while before I play the DLC. You guys won't notice that, because I'll end up playing it well before this playthrough actually gets completely posted. This episode in particular. But anyways, yeah. So I think I'll wrap that one up here. And I'll see all of you guys next time. Assuming there's not a post-credit scene. Bye! Lord Gwyn bequeathed most of his power to the gods, and burned his cinder for the first flame. Even so, Lord Gwyn's soul is a powerful thing indeed. Just thought you guys should get that. Adding that in.
Why is this in the first course?
Because it's the first course. And just like this, harder levels. Nice! Beautiful perfection.
I was aiming straight for him.
That was perfection.
Are we gonna have to save Bowser? Black! Well, this guy's weird. Oh, and all of Bowser's minions. And Luigi. Sheesh. Count Black's preparations are now in order. All that remains is for the dimensional void to appear, as foretold in the prophecy.